Good evening. Good evening, and welcome to Alee Academy's 2018 commencement ceremony. On behalf of the faculty and staff of Alee Academy and the graduating class of 2018, I would like to thank all of you for being a part of this very special moment in the lives of these young men and women, and for the love and support that each of you has shown them in order to help them get to where they are today. Please stand for the national anthem being led by Ms. Hope Seal. Please remain standing for the Pledge of Allegiance being recited by Ms. Tawana Sapp.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Ms. Princess Gill will now give the invocation.
Please bow your heads and pray. God, we come to you to say thank you for allowing this graduating class of 2018 and all our family and friends and to assemble ourselves together. Thank you, God, for standing by us and carrying us all these years. We ask that you be with us as we enter into our new life. Let the graduating class of 2018 not be distracted from what has gotten us through high school, which is you, Lord. We pray for your guidance and judgment as we face complicated decisions. God, thank you for Alee Academy for opening their doors when others turned us away. We ask you to bless the administrators and staff for all their love, support, and hard work. We ask you for a special blessing, God, for our wonderful parents, grandparents, and families for their love, encouragement, and all the help they have provided in getting us to this point. Realizing all things are possible through you, God, and without you, we are nothing. Thank you, God, for all you have done for us and we will continue to do for us. In your name we pray, amen.
Graduates, please stand and turn to the audience. Graduates, please give a round of applause to your parents, grandparents, family, and friends for supporting you and helping you get to this moment in your life. Thank you, graduates. You may be seated. I would like to take this opportunity to recognize some special people without whom none of this would be possible. If I could please have the charter board members please stand. Alee Academy's charter board supports the true mission of Alee Academy and allows the staff and administrators to continue to help those students in Lake County that need a second chance or an opportunity for a fresh start. We thank you for your tireless efforts and dedication to continue the mission of Alee Academy. Next, I would like to ask the staff of Alee Academy to please stand. These are the people day in and day out that fight the good fight to keep our students in school and encourage them to do better than they have previously been academically, socially, and morally. The staff of Alee Academy does not see their position at Alee Academy as a profession. For all of us, this is a mission. A mission to help those students that were not successful in the traditional schools and needed a fresh start, a new lease on life. Please join me in thanking the staff of Alee Academy for all they do on a daily basis. For all they do on a daily basis to help our students to not only get back on track, but to stay the course and make it a little bit closer to graduation each and every day. Thank you. Finally, I would like to ask our very dedicated lunch volunteers to please stand. Everyone knows lunch is the most important class of the day. We have been truly blessed again this year with daily help from Ms. Barbara Phelps, Ms. Diane Jenkins, and Mr. Donald Jenkins. Words cannot express how thankful we are that the three of you have stepped up to help out around the school in any way that you were needed. Thank you again for all that you have done for us this school year, and we look forward to working with you again next year. Lastly, I would like to recognize our community partners listed in your program. We thank them for all of their financial support, the partnerships they have with us, and the continued support of Alee Academy and its students in the community. We are happy to have any of those people here tonight, and we appreciate all that they do for Alee Academy. So thank you to our community partners. And now my turn. Here we are. Some say the end of the road. I say the beginning of the rest of your life. The choices you make for yourself and your response to the good times and bad times will define you. Know that the staff of Alee Academy believes in you, and the world is a better place for having had you in it with us. Use this fresh start to do something great, something unexpected, something worthwhile. The future is now, and no one but you can define what that will look like. As Albert Camus once said, life is the sum of your choices. And I always say, we all make choices, good ones and bad ones, and there's consequences to both. Choose wisely, for only you have control of your character. God bless and keep you as you go out to make your way in this world. The pleasure has been mine to have had the opportunity to work with you and see each of you mature and grow into the fine young men and women I knew you could be. Make me proud in whatever you choose to do with your life beyond high school, but know that Alee Academy will always be your home. Okay. Now it's time for your classmates to talk. So if I could have Kayla Smith and Dana Brewer, please.
Hi. Okay. So I just want to say congratulations, everybody. I'm really proud of y'all. Here we are after 12 long and hard years of late nights, procrastinating, and early mornings. We finally get to walk the stage just to receive a paper stating, hey, you're smart. During these past years, we have all put in a lot of work getting to where we are. For some of us, it has been easy, and others, well, we're surprised that we've made it this far. School has put us through many hardships, friendships, relationships, projects, groups, and tests, some of which we didn't know if we'd make it through alive. Many of us think our journey is over, but little do you know it's only begun. And as we turn this page in our book and start a new chapter, I know many of you guys won't keep moving on with me. Yet, I hope most of you turn the page with me and see what else we have coming for us. Now, with all of us gathered here, I just want to say congratulations. We made it somewhere that no one except some family and our Alee teachers thought we would make it. They believed in us and pushed us here. In all truth, we know none of us would be here without them. be able to experience this great achievement without them. So Alee teachers and staff, thank you so much for everything you've done for us. And I speak on behalf of class of 2018 and I say this, thank you and I love you guys. I would have made it this far without y'all.
Miss Dana Brewer.
Malcolm X once said, education is our passport to the future, for tomorrow belongs to the people who prepare for it today. My fellow classmates, we have spent the past 4 years getting to this day, and I am proud to be a part of Alee's 2018 graduating class. I know we have all had those people in our lives who have told us we weren't going to make it, then we came to Alee, and then we were told that we would never make it because of our school choice. Well, guys, look at us now. We are graduating, we not only broke their expectations, we exceeded them, and now we can say that we did it. Coming to Alee has honestly changed me. When I first started with these wonderful people, I was a quiet person, I stayed to myself, and I never really smiled. I was told I would only have to do half a year to get caught up, but in that little bit of a time, I became attached and wanted to stay. The reason I stayed was because I saw how much they all cared about their students. I'm sure I'm not alone. I bet each of us have our stories we could share about that the teachers and staff at Alee, unless you go here, you just don't understand. You really just have to experience being a part of this family to totally understand it. I experienced it, and after that, I am not sure what happened. I started smiling more. I actually started looking forward to school because Alee became like my home. And for that, I would like to give a special thanks to a few of the teachers and staff that brought me out of my shell. Miss J, AKA Mama Frog, Miss Emmerich, AKA Ginger Snap, Ms. Z, a.k.a. Rosebud, and Ms. Daniels, a.k.a. My Huckleberry. You guys have honestly become my family. I want to thank you for everything you've done for me, and I love you guys. Class of 2018, we have seen a lot of ups and downs, shared many laughs, and shed some tears along the way. But through all of that, we made it to this moment. We are all here because these people, the teachers, the staff, and the administration, our parents and friends, all pushed us to succeed. Sometimes that push came in the form of a good butt kicking. Thank goodness came the tough love. Congratulations, class of 2018. Remember, keep your chin up and keep looking to the future. Thank you.
Well, good evening, everyone. My name is Mike Holland, and I happen to be the chair of the board this year at Alee Academy, and I'm very proud of that. Guys, you've come a long way, and we're very proud of you as a board and as a staff of Alee Academy. Tonight, I get to lead in a very special part of this event, and that's to announce scholarships and awards. To start us off tonight, I'd like to ask Lori Dandria with Tanaj Salon to come forward.
Thank you. I have to share with all of you what an absolute pleasure it is to be here tonight. As I was getting ready to leave my home, I started thinking, and my main thought was tonight, with you graduating, this is your first step into adulthood. And I want you all, number one, to pat yourselves on the back for having this moment, for making things come true, and to be brave and to be strong and determined as you go through life. And most of all, to make the most of every moment. It goes by in a heartbeat. You won't believe how quickly the years go. The other thing I'd like to ask you to do, thank your parents, thank all the wonderful people who are sitting here who helped you. They are your support and they will always continue to be so. So, I just want to say for those of you not familiar with Tanaj Salon Institute, we train our students to work in the top 20% of the beauty industry, an industry that is booming right now. Everyone wants to look and feel good. And tonight I am here to present two special awards. The first is to Miss Tawana Sapp. And I am presenting her official letter of acceptance and saying we welcome you to the Tanaj family and are delighted to have you as a student. The next presentation is to Miss Santa Maria Charles. Samaria, I'm so sorry. Is she here? Oh, Samaria. Congratulations. Again, we're excited to have you as a student and welcome you to the Tanaj family. Thank you all.
The continuing education scholarships we will be awarding this evening are to be used as means for the students to continue their education by attending accredited post-secondary education institutions and colleges, universities, vo-technical schools. It is expected that they will enroll as a beginning freshman or continuing sophomore no later than this fall semester following their high school graduation. However, should the recipient delay enrollment into the accreditation institution, the continuing education scholarship shall become null and void after 2 years. This year, the school will be awarding over $8,000 in continuing education scholarships. First, the Kiwanis Club of Eustis with its president, Mr. Steve Molden. Steve?
Wow. First of all, I want to say congratulations to all the graduates tonight. And scholarship award sometimes is going to be it's not that it's a difficult decision, but sometimes it's a very, very, no coin tossing. It's getting down to the wire of just that person who is just rising. And you're all rising. I want to congratulate you for that, though. Tonight's scholarship, this year's recipient of the Kiwanis Club scholarship in the amount of $500 is to Ms. Kayla Smith. Kayla recognized the need to continue her education, which will enable her to realize her future plans. Her goal after high school is to continue and earn a degree and pursue a career as an emergency medical technician. Congratulations once again.
Thank you.
Thank you.
The next scholarship is the Christy Backall Memorial Scholarship. Daryl, would you like to come give that, please?
Congratulations, class of 2018. It is my pleasure to be able to speak to y'all and all of y'all this evening. I appreciate all of your parents and your family coming out to be a part of this, right? Be a part of this moment of your life. In a few minutes, I will step into my role as just a human being again. I'm no longer going to be that superhero that comes in and helps you guys out and brings you whatever it may be. Some of y'all, I provide crackers in the morning, whatever it may be, right? Superhero. I get to trade in my cape with you now. And I go from being coached to now I'm just Daryl, right? So I respect that role, right? And it's hard to turn in your cape sometimes, but it's a role that I learned to accept. And for you, your life is about to change too. Your role is about to change. For the last 12, 13, 14, 15, 16 years, you have got out of bed and you have put on your Alee t-shirt and you have come to school. For you, that is going to change. Your role is changing. I'm going to let that soak for a moment. Because now there's expectations, class of 2018. Guess what? Nobody's going to ask you what you want to be when you grow up anymore, guys. Now there's just expectations. But that's all right. There's nothing wrong with expectations. We expected this night to happen, and here you are. There's a lot and many that have said you guys would never be here. Way to prove them wrong. Congratulations. This is you deciding who you are going to be, and that's what roles are. Because now you are going to define who you are and the role that you have in life. Pick it for yourself. Because if you don't pick your role, do you know what happens? Someone decides who you are for you. You decide who you're going to be. Don't let anyone ever call you no count. Don't let anyone sell you for less than what you're worth. I was fortunate enough to be married to a woman who knew what she was worth, who knew her role, who had a passion for words, believed that words could change the world. No different than any poet or any songwriter, but her difference was she believed that she could change the way news was delivered. What she has in common with you is she was from a little town in Pennsylvania. I'm telling you guys, this town is so far back in the woods, Monday night football comes on Tuesday morning, okay? Little tiny town. Makes Eustis look like a metropolis. But she believed in her ability. She knew what her role was. And she worked going from writing obituaries in the Greensburg Time Review and working at her college library to being the entertainment editor for the New York Daily News, the sixth largest newspaper in the country, because she knew her role and knew what it was about. And tonight, I get to honor her memory and help give someone a helping hand so another small town person can make an impact on this world. I've known our recipient tonight for years. I've watched this person grow in front of me. Not easy all the time. Struggle, right? Because you know what? It's life, y'all. It's life. It's not easy. It has its ups. It has its downs. Just remember your King Solomon, and this too shall pass. Don't allow yourself to get too high. Don't allow yourself to get too low, right? And I loved this transformation. It's nice when you guys have been here for a while and I get to watch you grow and mature and turn into these wonderful people. So tonight, I get to extend my helping hand to Miss Jill Peterson.
Our next award is the Charles Davis Memorial Scholarship, tonight being given by Charles Davis III. Charles.
Congratulations to the class of 2018. Give yourselves a round of applause. You made it. For those who don't know, my father, he was a PE coach here. And unfortunately, in this past November, he passed away at the age of 43. He had health issues and But the biggest thing that I received out of that entire moment was the fact of leaving a legacy and how important that is. He taught me as a child, Charles, you have a purpose. Regardless what anyone says or does not do, you have a purpose. God has given you gifts, abilities, use them. And then he would laugh so loud, so hysterically. So for the students that had his class, you know exactly what I'm talking about. He had such a beautiful soul, but that message is the same message that I'm extending to you all. You have a purpose. Fulfill that purpose, find that purpose, grow in that purpose. Even if you have to go through adverse situations, continue to pursue because your life matters. Regardless of what society may say about you or may not say about you, understand that you have a purpose and the community around you supports you. I'm still a firm believer that it takes a village to raise a child. And the parents behind you, they're your village. The teachers up here, they're your village. So today we'll be extending our first annual Charles Davis Memorial Scholarship. And thank you. And I know this is something that he would love, because he had just a big heart. He wants to always help as much as he can. And there were numerous essays that were submitted, but today, Ms. Kayla Smith, you are the beneficiary of the first 2018 scholarship. And like I said before, Kayla wants to become an emergency medical technician. So congratulations, Kayla, and good luck with everything.
And our next scholarship is the Commitment to Community, given by Ms. Cindy Emmerich.
Well, here we are again, and I'm gonna try my darndest to get through this without tears. Thank you, Charles. Good evening, friends, family, and loved ones. Your support here tonight means so much to all of us and all of these young people sitting before you tonight. Your love, support, encouragement, and influence has helped set these graduates up for a successful future. To all of you, Alee Academy's class of 2018, this year has certainly been very difficult for all of us. We have experienced traumatic events, including the loss of a former student, and of course, our beloved Coach Davis. Our family has been tested, but through all of the adversity that you have faced this year and in all the years past, it is my hope that you are as proud of you as we are. Family and friends, many of you have seen the school shirts that your students wear to school. The original that we created a few years ago says TEAM on the back. And TEAM stands for Together Everyone Achieves More. That shirt means a lot to us. However, last year, during our National School Choice Week, our students created a shirt that displays their true feelings about Alee Academy, that this is their fam, Alee. And as an English teacher, I thought that was awful cute, play on words. So at Alee Academy, we haven't always had the best of reputations. We've often heard that it is a place for bad kids. Well, we know that that isn't true, but it has most definitely taken some work for others to see it. The change to our reputation had to begin inside our building, and it had to begin with our school family. And with that being said, I want to recognize the students that were charged with helping the teachers and staff this year as teacher assistants. They had a rough job sometimes because we did demand a lot of them. Miss Hope taught them to answer the phone. They did really get good at it, and some even learned to answer the phone with a smile. We taught them some basic office skills. Most of them became experts in making copies for all of you. We even taught them how to properly clean the cafeteria after lunch. And I promise that was not their most favorite part of the job. Please stand up when I call your name. Carla Sanchez. Jill Peterson. Laura Hamilton, Kayla Smith, Princess Gill, Dana Brewer, and Gabby Gibson. I am very proud of all of you ladies. Thank you for working so hard this year. You may be seated. So each year, we award a scholarship to a student that demonstrates a commitment to making the community a better place. However, this year we focused on students that help make our school community a better place. These four students demonstrated their commitment to their school by attending school almost every day and giving of themselves to help make Alee Academy a better place. Each recipient of the Commitment to Community Award will be given $250. Please help me in congratulating Miss Dana Brewer, Miss Carla Sanchez, Miss Gabby Gibson, and Miss Kayla Smith. Congratulations again, and thank you, all of you, for your commitment to the community of Alee Academy.
It will be my honor to give the next five or six awards, so just bear with me as I read these. The first one is the Steve and Kyleen Fisher Memorial Scholarship. Steve and Kyleen Fisher always believed in helping those who needed a hand up versus a hand out. They would always go out of their way to assist a young man or a young lady who was diligently working to achieve things that would further his or her education to improve the status of life. The first recipient of $500 Steve and Kyleen Fisher Memorial Scholarship is Laura Hamilton. Laura is planning to continue her education at a technical school. Second recipient of $500 of the Steve and Kyleen Fisher Memorial Scholarship is Princess Gill. Princess is planning to continue her education and to pursue a career in special education. Laura and Princess has displayed the same determination as the people of these scholarships are named after. Congratulations to the 2018 Steve and Kyleen Fisher Memorial Scholarship recipient, Mrs. Laura Hamilton and Princess Gill. Congratulations. The next scholarship is the Lake Technical College. Lake Technical College awards a scholarship each year to the student that submits a timely application, including an essay as to why the student deserves the career in a year scholarship. This year, Lake Technical College has awarded a scholarship to an Alee Academy student in the amount of $1,000. Congratulations to Sierra Richardson. The next scholarship is the Nick Kelly Scholarship. Nick Kelly enrolled as a ninth grade student at Alee Academy in 2000 school year. During the year, Nick struggled to keep up with his academics, but in 2001 school year, Nick returned with a new attitude. He attacked each class with a renewed desire to become successful in his academics. Nick now had a goal to complete his high school education. However, in December of 2001, Nick passed away. Each year, a graduate is awarded a $500 scholarship that best exemplifies those traits displayed by Nick Kelly. The recipient of the 2018 Nick Kelly Scholarship is Alicia Philman. She will be continuing her education in a degree in nursing. Congratulations. Our next scholarship is the Citizenship Scholarship. This $1,000 scholarship is awarded to a student who exhibits the four citizenship traits of trustworthiness, fairness, self-control, respect for authority, selves, and others. Congratulations to this year's Samaria Charles. And Samaria is going to be continuing her education at Tenage in cosmetology. The next scholarship is the Chairman Scholarship. The Chairman Scholarship is in the amount of $750, is awarded to a student that excels academically within the year. This year, we have two recipients who not only excelled in academically, but exemplified the drive and determination to persevere through challenges. The first recipient of $750 Chairman Scholarship is Dana Brewer. Dana has completed her high school courses requirements with a 2.93 GPA. Dana intends to continue her education in the near future to pursue a career in nursing. Congratulations, Dana. The second recipient of a $750 Chairman Scholarship is Michelle Sheffield. Michelle completed her high school course requirements with a 3.20 GPA. Michelle intends to continue her education in the near future to pursue a career in massage therapy. Congratulations, Michelle. And our last scholarship, the Outstanding Senior Scholarship. The final award this evening is in the amount of $1,500. This scholarship is based on the student's academic achievements, positive influence in the classroom and around campus, as well as their professional potential. Congratulations to the recipient of the 2018 Outstanding Senior Scholarship, Jessica Arms. Jessa is completing her high school career with a 3.81 GPA. Knowing the importance of furthering her education, Jessica will go on to pursue a degree in nursing. Jessica, congratulations.
Okay, and now the moment we've all been waiting for. Presentation of diplomas. So first row, watch for Ms. Emmerich.
Shakita Daisy Addison. Tyrick Amonte Atkins. Jessica Faith Arms. Alana Ashlyn Beach. Dana Renee Brewer. Samaria Valise Charles. Brooke Michaela Connors. Yeah.
Reagan Starla Doris. Alyssa Ray Philman. Thomas William Forshee. Princess Cheyenne Gill. Maria Miranella Gira. Laura Lynn Hamilton. Cameron Tyler Hollis. Thomas Richard Horton. Samantha Shanice Johnson. Cameron Michael Crozergo. Alec Hunter Lamond. Faith Ashley Lampkin. Gabriella Ray Lee Gibson. Tiara Denaja Lewis. Dion Antonio Banner. Haley Nicole Maxwell. Jakiria Lakita McLeod. Tanisha LaShawn McKenzie. Marcus Scott McMullen. Mahogany Brandy Moten. Ethan Lewis Navala. Carlos Enrique Nunez. Jasmine Orr. Jillian Ray Peterson. Malik Howard Powell. Kendarius Leandre Prince. Ciara Christine Richardson. Zion Kyrie Rogers. Salvador Salazar. Rolina Sam. Carla Yaret Sanchez. Thank you.
Tawana Lakira Sepp. Michelle Jean Sheffield. Kayla Marie Smith. Sherman Isaiah Smith. Deidre Lachey Solomon. Brandon Scott Stevens Kennard. Eric Victor Torres. Randall Austin Vance. Micaiah Lynn Walden. Adam Lee Wiggins.
Ladies and gentlemen, as we close this evening, I'd like to thank you for your patience and all that you've done to make this night possible. We've got one more thing to do, but before I do that, I would like to encourage each of you sitting in this room to do one thing for me as you leave here. Realize that education is the backbone to every community. If these are your last students in school, please don't stop supporting Alee Academy and the public school system in our community, because the best economic development tool and the best way we grow our communities is through what this school is doing. So I encourage you, if you want to give a dollar or two, that's fine. But what we need you to do more than anything is invest time in the lives of students. So I encourage you, please do that as we go forward in the next few years. Graduates, would you please stand for me? Guys, over the course of this year, it's been fun getting to know each one of you. It's been fun hanging out with you today. As you came by me a little earlier, I get to talk to you all and find out what you want to do with your lives. If you will follow what's in your heart, you will make those dreams come true. Don't let tonight stop your education process. The learning process stays until the day you die. Continue to learn. Continue to be a positive influence in your community, in your family. Keep God first and keep your family a close second, and you will succeed. If you'll grab a hold of those tassels, don't move them yet. On behalf of the board of directors of this school and the education department of the state of Florida, you have met the requirements of our great state. You can move those tassels. You are graduates. One more second and I'll let you out of here. Graduates, you have pictures that are over here if you want to pick those up. Families, those pictures are available for you over here in the corner. Again, on behalf of our staff, our administration, and our board, thank you for being here tonight, and you are dismissed.